here we are into the last new character for patch 2.5, Mose. Right now I will just stick to Mose since I don't know how to pronounce his name. We just recently received one of the best 4 star, which is the Hunt variation of March 7. And it turned out another Hunt 4 star will come out, and is he gonna be good? Is he gonna be 4 star to pass? Or is he the type of unit that will be benched on your account once you accidentally get him? Don't worry, today's video will discuss all of his kit, including his damage output and pros and cons as well. I know it's been a week since his V1, but better late than never, right? So, let's get started. So Mose is a 4 star Hunt Lightning character. He's actually a DPS that is working behind his ally's shadow since he will disappear in the action bar, but still dealing additional damage every time his allies attack the prey mark that is inflicted by him. He is also capable to perform follow-up attack at certain conditions, as well as increase the crit damage ability from his ally. He has 546 as his base attack and 114 speed, which is nice and understandable, since most assassins need to move swiftly to kill their prey without anyone noticing, right? While his trait stats are crit damage, attack boost, and HP. He's not going to use his basic attack as his killing method. It's just dealing damage equal to 100% of Mose's attack to a single enemy. And to me, his skill is the one that is going to be the main core of his kit. He will designate one enemy to be inflicted with a prey mark, and then deals damage to that single enemy. This mark will be gone once his allies are all defeated, and thus he also cannot use this skill. This ability is the key to activate his talent, where he will enter a departed state when the prey mark exists in the battlefield. This state means he will be gone from the action order, thus cannot be targeted, and takes action. Every time a party member hit the enemy with this mark, Mose will launch a small additional damage and then gain 1 charge. Once he reaches 7 charge, he can then perform a follow-up attack to that enemy as well as dispelling the prey mark. His ultimate is simple, unlike any other units that we previously discussed. He has 110 energy cost and will deal significant damage to a single enemy as well as increase his damage dealt by 50% for 2 turns beforehand. He can also enter the stealth mode that lasts for 20 seconds if you activate his technique, and the enemy will obviously won't detect his presence. After he attacks an enemy to enter combat, his action will be advanced forward by 50% and his damage dealt increased by 30% for 1 turn. Since Mose cannot take action once he is in a departed state and won't consume any of your skill points, but he can still be an SP positive unit thanks to his A2. He will generate 1 skill point after he performs follow-up attack from his talent, and this can only be done once per turn. Not that much, but considering he is a Hunt unit, this actually kind of decent. Wait, never mind, I take back what I have just said. Instead going to be an SP positive, he will be SP neutral or even still negative, considering he still needs to apply another marking prayer once he returns from his slumber. And then his A4 lets his action advance forward by 30% once his departed state is ended. But if Mose's current charge is equal to 4 or greater, his action will be advanced forward by 60% instead. This trait is actually important too, unlike Robin, who also disappears from the action bar, but she will immediately take action after her concerto state ends. Mose cannot do that after the prey mark and his departed state ends. That is why his huge base speed is understandable, and this A2 pushes him to immediately take action again. His A6 is where his support ability is located. Every time his party members deal damage to a marked target, their crit damage will be increased by 20%. So he's going to deal damage, can generate SP, and also care about others by technically giving them 20% crit damage, yet his E0 might still be very lackluster. So that's why we need to take a peek at his Eidolons. Are they going to change anything, or still make him underwhelming? His first Eidolon max, his ultimate is considered as launching a follow-up attack. This means he can benefit from any follow-up attack buffs, like Nambi's debuff for example. And not only that, he also increases the enemy's follow-up damage taken by 25%, or only half of Battle Pass good over. His second one is also important since now every time his additional damage from talent is triggered, he will generate 3 energy. He also immediately generates 20 energy at the start of the battle. Fourth Eidolon is basically giving your team more crit damage. Previously I said that E0 Mose is somewhere between SP neutral to SP negative, but thanks to his last Eidolon, he will be a unit that is still SP neutral but can lead towards SP positive a bit. Every time he casts his ultimate, he will then immediately launch a follow-up attack from his talent, making him deal more consistent damage. To me, his second Eidolon is what makes him a 4-star unit as a whole. Having his E2 means you unlock his first Eidolon, which gives him access to be more useful for follow-up teams since he can now give 20% vulnerability for them and to himself also. His additional energy regeneration may not be much, but it will be at least improve his performance and enable him cast his ultimate faster to do more damage. Since once he is in a demoted state, all he needs is his own allies to proc his additional damage while generating his energy. To me, the reason why his ultimate is as important is because to rely only on his additional damage might not be a great idea, since the number sucks and the follow-up damage number may be just decent, and to trigger it you must collect 7 charges. And there is no guarantee that his follow-up ability will land in crit hits once you desperately collect it. And it turns out in his Eidolon, there are no improvements for him to gain easier access to generate faster stack, unless you have him at E6. So how much is his personal damage? Let's play a little bit with some numbers now. Assuming he is at least at Eidolon 2 and using S5 the final victor for his light cone, and then for his relic I'm going to be using the combination of 2-piece debuff with attack. His crit stats are 65% crit rate with 130% crit damage. For this calculation I'm going to use Avengerine, Topaz and Robin as well. Note that this build may not be his best option. It's just to show some of his numbers with hopefully the correct team composition. And here it is. These numbers are already include Robin's additional attack from ultimate and her additional damage as well. Mose's additional damage if crit is around 3k per hit. It's actually not significant. His ultimate having a higher multiplier than the rest is also not really a game changer. His numbers are basically decent, especially his follow-up attacks. It's going to be a quiet effort to activate his follow-up attack. So that's why I think instead of E2, it is recommended to get his full Eidolons for this V1. I guess at this rate, it is safe to say that he is not a replacement for Topaz in Fei Xiao teams. So if you are pulling for Fei Xiao and want to pick her base team candidates, I think it's going to be a competition between Marsh 7 or Topaz now. Mose is out. Well, it's not that he is completely out, but his E6 is better for Fei Xiao's team, I guess. The Hunt Marsh and Mose share almost many similarities. They both have a stacking mechanism that relies on their allies to quickly charge it so that they both can perform their abilities. Overall, Marsh is more comforting to play, and here is the reason. Marsh is going to designate one ally as her master and that's it. It stays like that. No duration until the match is over and she is present on the battlefield, thus can take action by using her basic attacks so that she can generate SP for the whole team. As for Mose, he is going to choose one enemy to be marked with prey, but once they die or he successfully perform follow-up attack, the mark is gone now, and he needs to reply it again by using his skill. And what makes him a burden to the other party members is that he has completely disappeared, like kidnapped by Swarov's hand. So, no action means no SP generation. His A2 traits can help him, but it takes quite an effort to get there. Not gonna lie, it is also the same with Marge. 7 stacks can be pretty exhausting, but it's definitely more worth it for her, as her enhanced basic attack can deal tons of damage or even 4 to 5 times more than Mose's follow-up attack damage. Her enhanced basic attack also offers other utilities such as toughness breaking, and she can reduce enemy's toughness based on her Shifu's elements type. So her 7 charge is way more worth it than Mose's. So I guess it's better to give Mose more rewards if we successfully get him 7 charges. On top of that, Marsh is a free unit, literally complete with her full Eidolons. So I'm hoping that they will make more great adjustments for Mozi in V3 later on. And honestly, if that time comes, I will be so excited to make a video about his changes. Looking at the bright side, despite being a damage dealer, Mozi also has other supportive utility. He can increase his team members' crit damage by using his Mark Prey. And this is going to be better with his Eidolons, where he gives 25% vulnerability damage from follow-up attack from his second Eidolon and give more crit buffs from his fourth one. He also enables his own ultimate to be regarded as launching follow-up attack. This can bring more potential advantages for himself. So overall, pretty good Eidolons. He also has a cool concept and a lore for accurate assassins, where they usually lurk in the dark, and when the right time comes, they will unleash a sneak attack to kill their prey. This is probably what his stacking and follow-up kit is based on, but somehow it is not implemented to his kit in the right way. His follow-up multiplier is basically just decent, so it's not really worth it to stacking up to 7 charges to activate his sneak attack or follow-up attack. The devs probably need to take a look at this and maybe should have made his multiplier higher since he is a single target oriented unit. Mozi can also be said to be SP negative. This is because he will disappear and won't have his turn or action to generate SP for his members. He will consume SP, applying mark, and refuses to elaborate any further and then leave. What makes his marking prey very lackluster is that it will be dispelled after the enemy dies and after he launches his follow-up attack, so he needs to reapply it again to another enemy. This is what makes him a not SP friendly unit. It could have been better if the marking prey is moved to the other remaining enemy if they died, or maybe can still remain even after Mozi performs his follow-up attack. Other thing that makes Mozi feel underwhelming is that he disappears. I know that's how most assassins work, their screen time has to be as limited as possible, but his disappearance brings several drawbacks to himself or even his team. He completely relies on his party members to perform as many actions as they can, but if there is a situation where they all get crowd controlled or their turns delayed, Mozi will still kept in the dark, like he's dead. This will further result in DPS loss and even prolong the cycle. In addition, he also won't get a team-wide party buff or even party-wide shields and heals. His additional damage is also sucks that it barely contributes to team's damage output and don't have a fixed crit. Yes, the damage is already a small one to begin with and might still result with non-crit hits. So overall, I think Mozi's kit definitely needs to be adjusted. It's either his multiplier or his buffing abilities. Thankfully, this is just V1. If they release him like this, it's pretty sad since the concept of this character itself is already cool. So what do you guys think about Mozi? Need more buffs or you don't really care since he is a 4-star anyway? Let me know in the comments. You can also state what kind of buffs that he should be getting in the future. If you enjoy watching this video, please make sure to support this channel by press the like button and subscribing as well. I will be back with all of their V3 changes along with their possible builds. So stay tuned. Have a beautiful day and I will see you humans in the next video.